Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Megan with Her Courage to Plan. Today we've got to update our debt and savings trackers for the month of June. Now, if you missed our debt and savings tracker update for the month of May, I will link it up above and you can go back and check it out if you so desire. So without further delay, let's go ahead and get right into the update. All right, guys, so I am at the saving funds tracker for the month of June. And if you are liking this spreadsheet, this is part of my new 12-month paycheck to paycheck budget journal. I do have the link down below in the description box. If you want to check out the journal, it is a nice streamlined journal and it has a host of different spreadsheets, guys. And it also comes with your monthly savings tracker jars, and also it comes with your debt payoff tracker monthly jars. And of course, I do give you a bonus. I give you bill due and payday stickers, guys. So please make sure you check out my Etsy shop if you are interested in getting your hands on this 12-month budget journal. Now, I am going to be using these Parku pens that I have been loving thus far, guys. If you want to get your hands on it, I do have a link down below in the description box. And I think I'm going to use the black today. These pens write so lovely. All right, so we're going to start with our household emergency fund. So right now, we are focused on building up our household emergency fund, and we are working on our 1 month goal. If you missed that video where I did a detail of how we came up with our goals for our 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, and 12 month goal for our emergency fund, I'll link it up above and you can go back and check that video out, guys. It was a detailed video and you want to make sure you go and look at that, because right now savings is on the forefront of everybody's minds, especially during this pandemic, and we just need to make sure that we're saving as much as we can. Now, speaking of savings, guys, I was interviewed on the Money Mondays live show with Rochelle Adamson, and we talked all things savings. So please make sure you go back and check out the replay. I'm going to link it up above and also have it in the description box. And also, Rochelle, she did give some awesome tips on how to save your first $100,000. So please make sure you go back and check that video out if you're wanting some tips and some ideas of just, you know, where to start. Guys, we talked about it all and we had fun doing it. So please make sure you check that video out. So for our household emergency fund, our starting balance was $1,072.26, and we didn't have any withdrawals, but we did have a nice size deposit for the month of June. So our total deposit was $762.83. So our ending balance in that fund will total $1,072.26 plus the deposit of $762.83. So we have a total of $1,835.09 in that account. All right, so our next savings category is our son's tuition. Many of you all know that we are cash flowing our son's college education while we're slowly paying off debt, and of course we are focused on our emergency fund. So we do have a lot of moving parts here. We are blessed and we're so thankful that we are able to cash flow his tuition, where he would at least have his first degree debt free. So that is just awesome. We are so excited, and of course he is excited as well. So our starting balance was $305 in this account. We didn't have any withdrawals, and we did deposit the $150. So we have a total of $455 in this account. Now, we will be withdrawing out of this account to make sure that we pay for his tuition. So this here account will never be, you know, a really huge amount that's sitting in it, because we do periodically, we will withdraw out of it to pay for his tuition. So his tuition, he does go back to school in August. So we definitely know that we will do a withdrawal from this account. All right. And so for our vacation, we are still cash flowing our vacation, And last year in October was our first debt-free vacation, guys. And I'm telling you, we had a wonderful time. We cash flowed it, and it was actually our vacation slash retreat. I did a vlog, part one and part two. I'll leave that up above if you want to go and just check it out. We had a beautiful time, guys. And we are still saving for our vacation for this year. So we hope that we will be able to take a vacation. We know there's a lot of things going on, but we're just going to continue to put in this fund because eventually we will be going on vacation at some point. So our starting balance was $947.52. We did not make any withdrawals, and we did deposit $100 for the month of June. So our total, $947.52 plus $100, $1047.52 is the ending balance for the vacation fund. So I like to go ahead and total the starting balances because I like to go ahead and bring it down. So our starting balance is $1072.26 plus $305 plus $947.52. We started out with $2324.78 in all the funds, no withdrawals, and our total deposits for the month of June, $762.83, $150, and $100. So our total, $1012.83. So guys, we put in over $1,000 in our savings funds, and that is just awesome. And our ending balances in all the funds come to, so we got $1835.09 plus $455 and $1047.52. So our ending balances in all of the funds is a total of $3,337.61. And that is awesome, guys. So we are just excited. We did really well for the month of June for our savings. So now we get to go ahead and update our debt payoff trackers. All right, guys, so we are at the debt payoff tracker for the month of June, and the debt that we are currently focused on is our HELOC, our home equity line of credit. Now our receipts look a little different from May because the bank, they changed over systems, so it's a little bit different, but I do like that they do have home equity line of credit listed here. So I just highlighted the new balance so that we can kind of see it a little bit better. So for June 26th, as you can see here, we did make our $125 payment, and this was the regular payment. So I go ahead and fill this in for the 26th, and of course it was our HELOC. I am loving this pen, guys. It writes really nicely. And it says our beginning balance, which is our previous balance, $2432.53. And then our minimum payment was the $125. And on this day, there was no extra payment, and our total payment was $125. And then our ending balance, as you see, our new balance came to $2318.73. So that is awesome. We are making headway. Even though it's slow, we can still see the light at the end. So this was done in person. And then I went back on June 30th and paid another $125. So I go ahead and put this in June 30th, HELOC. And the starting balance you see here, $2318.73. And then this was not the minimum payment, but this was the extra payment. So this is where I'm documenting that. And the total payment, $125. So our new balance, $2195.25, which is awesome sauce, guys. And you can see we did not pay a whole lot of interest. So the interest we're paying is $1.52 on this particular payment. So we are super excited, guys. We are making headway, and we are almost below $2,000. So what I like to do is I just bring down a few of these columns. The minimum payment, of course, $125. the extra payment, $125. And then the total payment, we do know that that's $250. So $125 plus $125, $250. And our ending balance, we just bring that ending balance down, $2195.25. All right, guys, so I am finished filling out this particular debt payoff tracker. So now let's get into the fun part. We've got to get to shading. So we're going to update our monthly jars and we're going to update our large jar. All right, guys, so I am at the debt tracker section of my budget planner. Now, I do have a bundle of inspirational quotes and affirmations that are in my Etsy shop, and I have the link down below. And this one here, I just, of course, printed it on vellum. I just love different quotes and inspiration throughout my planner because, of course, it helps keep me motivated. And I just love the fact that I have built my own DIY budget planner and I get to, you know, just make it my own. And it does reflect who I am and what I stand for. I did print this on vellum. Vellum is very cheap, guys. I got the vellum from Hobby Lobby, but if you've got some premium paper, it'll look just as beautiful. So if you want to get your hands on these affirmation and quotes bundle, I have the link to my Etsy shop down below. All right, guys, so we are at the monthly jars, and for the month of June we paid a total of $250. So I just plug this in here. And before I get to shading, we are at the end of the second quarter. So I'm going to go ahead and do a total and put in our second quarter totals debt paid. So for April, we paid $175, for May, $250, and then for June, $250. So for the second quarter, guys, we pay a total of $675, which is amazing. That is just awesome, guys. So let's go ahead and get to shading. Alright, guys, so that felt amazing. So let's go ahead and fill in our large jar. All right, guys, so we are at the large debt payoff tracker jar, and I'm going to go ahead and fill in our total amount that was paid for the second quarter on this tracker. So it's $675. And then as far as our balance, we know that our balance is $21.95.25 for the HELOC. So we get to shade not quite here to this line, but we can shade just above it, guys. So I will see you back in a bit. Guys, that felt amazing. So we have finished filling in our debt payoff tracker jars. I hope you all enjoyed this video, guys. Let me know down in the comment section, are you focused on paying off debt or building up your savings funds during this time? All right, guys, you already know the deal. I'll see you later. Bye.